our industry in general is not innovating enough. And we have the chance to have a huge amount of talent in Canada. We could, if governments and industry change a bit their culture around investment in technology and innovation, we could really accelerate the economic development with AI. The other thing really related to the pandemic itself is the way that we do innovation for public good. So I've talked about antibiotics, but one thing I didn't say is that the market forces for solving this problem are not well aligned, that it's not commercially profitable to do research on this right now. And so governments need to find a way to stimulate innovation in those directions that can help us fight climate change, prepared for the next pandemic. And we don't have the right structure there to do that. Economically, it could be huge. So I think we need to rethink our innovation pipeline, not just to improve the efficiency of our industry, but also to solve these societal problems that currently markets are not addressing properly.
So how concerned are you on the social impact of artificial intelligence?
It is one of the concerns and the things that sometimes keep me awake at night. Any technology that is powerful can be abused. And we can't rely on the goodwill of people only to keep those potential problems in check. We need governments to set the rules of the game like they have done in other industries like airlines or just transportation, right? So there's all kinds of security regulations that exist in many fields, but not so much in the computing field. But now we're starting to see social consequences, and AI in particular is crucial because it can be so powerful and it could influence our democracies.